कर समझा मेरे होठों पे ठहर जा, मैं ख्वाब ख्वाब सा तेरी आंखों में जागू रे, तू इश्क इश्क सा मेरे रूह में आके बस जा, जिस ओर तेरी शहनाई उस ओर मैं भागू रे।
मुस्कुराना भी तुझसे सीखा है, दिल लगाने का तू ही तरीका है, एतबार भी तुझसे होता है।
Now ready to commence with the nikah ceremony for the Sayyid and Basit families. It is my honor and privilege to welcome Iman, our bride, accompanied with her father, Abdul Basit, and brother, Hamza Basit.
عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه ما بعد. First of all, I'd like to welcome everyone to the nikah ceremony of Taha and Iman. I'm sure they greatly appreciate your presence and are in need of your du'as as they begin this very important journey together. Before we start, I would like to ask formal permission from Abdul Basit Saab and Salim Saab if I can start the nikah, inshallah. So I'm sure many of you already know how a nikah ceremony works. It's very simple, straightforward. Whatever I do recite in the very beginning, I will translate for the benefit of everyone, inshallah. And we move on to the ijab and qabul, where Taha will propose and I will intermediate on his behalf. And inshallah, Iman will accept. Inshallah. After that, we will sign the nikah certificate and we will end with a few words and a short dua, inshallah. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أرسله بالحق بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة من يطع الله ورسوله فقد رشد ومن يعصهما فإنه لا يضر إلا نفسه ولا يضر الله شيئا أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم النكاح من سنتي فقال فمن رغب عن سنتي فليس مني أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. After praising Allah and sending salutations upon His beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, I recited three verses of the Quran that are traditionally recited in a nikah ceremony, each one reminding us of a specific purpose. First and foremost, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us that we are all created from Adam alayhi salam and Hawa alayhi salatu wasalam, and reminds us of our purpose in this world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, through that reminder, also teaches us that it is human nature to look for a companionship. a person can be materially successful in this world, they can have all the possessions that they want, but if they don't have anybody to share it with, somebody who will share their burden, somebody who will share their joy, somebody who will share their sorrows, they will always find their lives lacking. They will always find something missing. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created this institution of nikah so that each and every one of us can have a partner that will allow us to grow closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala together. The second verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us to fear Him as He ought to be feared. And it is an apt reminder because nikah is a relationship that requires trust and has rights and responsibilities. Each party has rights and responsibilities to the other. And because we are human beings, we remind ourselves of the fact that we are all going to be held accountable one day in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I will be asked about the responsibilities that I had and the rights that others had over me. And even though we are human beings and we will make mistakes, we are not expected to be perfect, we cannot be perfect, we remind ourselves of the fact that we should still try our best to fulfill whatever obligations others have on us, especially in a relationship like this. And lastly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us to speak the truth, because a relationship like this requires trust and honesty. The foundation has to be based on trust. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us of the fact that even though it is very difficult to sometimes speak the truth, we should always be truthful, first and foremost with our relationship with Allah, and of course with our relationship with the other creations of Allah, every single person who is within our lives. We move on to the last part of the nikah ceremony, which is essentially the ijab and qubul. The ijab and qubul is me asking first and foremost Taha, and then of course moving on to iman. Begin with Taha. So it's not an interrogation, so you should be fine. So do you, Taha Salim Sayyid, take Iman Basit into your nikah for the mahar that was agreed upon between the two of you and between your families? Do you accept her into your nikah with all of these conditions in the presence of family, friends, and witnesses? Do you accept her into your nikah?
Yes, I do.
Two more times.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Alhamdulillah. And now we move on to Iman. So I will pass Iman the microphone and I will ask her the same question, which is, do you, Iman Basit, take Taha Salim Sayyid into your nikah for the mahar that was agreed upon between the two of you and was agreed upon by your families? In the presence of family, friends, and witnesses, do you accept him into your nikah?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Yes, I do.
Okay. Round of applause for the bride and groom. So, this, of course, is a verbal confirmation. We will move on to a written confirmation, which is essentially just signing a nikah certificate to formalize the process. We will first start with Abdul Basit Saab. And because their families love them so much, we have four witnesses, inshallah. So the first witness, Muhammad Khalid Saab, if you can please come up to the stage. Jazakallah. Sohil Saab. Imtiaz Saab. And lastly, we now move on to the bride and the groom. So we'll go in the same order. Taha first. And Iman. And I will also add, inshallah. So traditionally in a nikah ceremony, the imam is supposed to mention a few words before the dua. So right before we started, Munir Saab happened to ask me how many nikahs I had performed. And I don't keep exact track, but I know it's in the 70s right now. The first nikah I performed was in 2013, and alhamdulillah, have been continuing since then. The ironic thing is majority of my nikahs were before my own nikah. I got married, alhamdulillah, in 2016, and majority of it was before. And I'm sure you can see the irony, because I was a single person trying to give marriage advice to people who are going to be married when I had no experience whatsoever. And I used to say whatever I thought was going to be the most romantic was going to be what people wanted to hear. And for talking points and just out of curiosity, I used to talk to the families of the bride and the groom whenever I used to come early, the aunties and the uncles, chachas, chachis, usually the elderly couples. And I used to ask them, how long have you been married? And they would say 20 years, 30 years, 50 years. And I would ask them, if you had to give one piece of advice, what would you say? Because I had no idea, so I wanted talking points. And it was very interesting, because majority of the advices that I used to hear revolved around three words that I chose, and I think is a good reminder for all of us. It's the three C's of marriage. Of course, there is much more. Anybody who is married knows that there's no secret recipe. It requires a lot of work and effort at the end of the day, but you can take some highlights. So the first C is always compliment. Always compliment. As human beings, we appreciate being noticed, recognized. We appreciate our efforts being recognized. And complimenting is the best way to do so. In the beginning, it's more natural, because everything is naya, maza, and you want to say everything, mashallah, this looks great, this tastes great. But after a while, when things become normal, when normal life takes over, the compliments usually stop. If there's no compliments, that means there's a compliment there. I didn't complain, so that must mean it's good, right? That's usually how some people take it. But that shouldn't be the case. There should always be an effort to always compliment each other, even if it's something very small and seemingly insignificant, saying thank you, and I like this, or you look nice, or thank you for this, thank you for that. It's very small, but it has a tremendous impact. And it also does not let you take the other person for granted. All right? As long as you compliment, you are always recognizing their efforts, and the person will always feel, whether they're the husband or the wife, they'll always feel that their efforts are being appreciated. So that's number one, always compliment. Number two, always communicate, because we're not mind readers. We don't know what the other person thinks. It's not healthy to try to make the other person guess, you know, figure out why am I in a mood, right? No, tell me, right? And of course, there's multiple steps to that, but the idea is that there should always be communication, right? We should always be upfront and honest and truthful with each other, and of course that requires a lot of trial and error. It requires tact, it requires wisdom, something that you just learn over time. Again, there is no secret formula. You just have to figure it out. But the idea is that you always communicate, you always speak with each other and keep channels of communication open. And lastly, always compromise, because it's not my way or the highway. That doesn't work. Compromising is necessary because it's two human beings who have different ideas of how something should be done. And certain times it requires compromising, even if it means giving up your own share, or if it means giving up your own right to make the other person happy. And again, it should be a two-way street. There should always be compromise from both sides. But the idea is it should never be just what one person wants, right? It should always be a combined effort. You know, somebody once told me that marriage is like tending a garden, that you need the right amount of attention, the right amount of ingredients, because if you put too much attention, there's always going to be problems. If you give no attention, there's also going to be problems. So it has to be just right. And at the end of the day, we are human beings. Allah did not create us to be perfect. We're not expected to be perfect. We cannot be perfect. So it's up to the couple and for, you know, Taha and Iman, who are just starting off, but also for any of us who are in any relationship, but of course specifically in the context of a nikah, to always remind ourselves of our own faults. Right, we're not perfect, and certain times when we feel anger or displeasure, it's always worthwhile thinking of all the good that was done, all the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has provided, and inshallah that's a way forward. So I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless Taha and Iman's nikah, that the love that they have for each other grows every single day, that they are there for each other in the darkest of days, in the most happiest of days, that they are there to share with each other their joys and their sorrows, that they help each other grow as human beings, as Muslims, that they help each other grow closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them happiness, health, and success in this world and in the next. We will end with a very short dua. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wal aqibatu lil muttaqeen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa in lam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna min al-khasirin. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azab an-nar. Rabbi irhamhuma kama rabbayani saghira. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا
اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى من القول والفعل والعمل والنية والهدي إنك على كل شيء قدير اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.
A round of applause for the bride and groom.
तुझे मुझसे मिलाया है तुझे मुझसे मिलाया है तुझ पे मर के ही तो तुझ पे मर के ही तो मुझे जीना आया है मुझे जीना आया है कोई दिल बेकाब
काबू कर गया और इश्क का दिल में भर गया, आँखों आँखों में वो लाखों गल्ला कर गया वे, और दम तो भर गया शुदाई मुझे कर गया वे, और अब मैं तो मर गया वे.
Today we're celebrating the joining of two esteemed and respected families in our community. And in doing so tonight, we are in for some incredible performances and some classic Pakistani hospitality. We're preparing for the grand royal entrance of the Sayyid family. And I recommend everybody have their phones out because this is definitely something you want to get on your cameras. Ladies and gentlemen, if I could please have everybody turn their attention to the main entrance. It is my honor and privilege. Let us all welcome the Sayyid clan! Gentlemen, let's make some noise for the Sayyid family. What an incredible and royal entrance that was. Sayyid family, let's stay on the dance floor. We need you guys still on the dance floor. Because we have another family that we need to welcome. We need to welcome them with open arms and with a lot of love. Because you know what? I think your guys' family just grew. Alhamdulillah, your family just grew by one more person. So if I could please have the Sayyid family, anybody wants to join them, we're all going to welcome all together. Let's show some love in welcoming the lovely, the amazing, the respected Basit Clan!
तू बच के रही, नहीं तू हुने हुने होई मुटियार, मुंडियां तू बच के रही.
What a beautiful entrance. Mashallah, mashallah. All right, to all the guests in attendance of this incredible Mehndi celebration, are you guys ready for this? Everyone's ready? We need everybody to get loud. We need to get loud. Everybody ready? Did you hear that? Everyone's waiting for you. Everyone's waiting. All right, ladies and gentlemen, for the first time, it is my honor and privilege to welcome Taha and Iman Sayed! The Sayed and Basit families dance together. The Sayed family, the Basit family, would like you to please have the dinner first. So Sayyid family, please, out of respect, we would like you to please line up and please have some dinner. The naans are fresh and hot, right from the tawa. The nihari has been cooked all day, and it's all fresh, hot, and ready to be eaten. So please, line up. Please join me in welcoming our first performance of the night, which is going to be done by Iman's parents. Please welcome Abdul and Nasreen Basit.
Thank you. زہر جبھی تجھے معلوم نہیں تو ابھی تک ہے ہسی اور میں جوان تجھ پہ قربان میری جان میری جان اے میری زہر جبھی تجھے معلوم نہیں تو ابھی تک ہے ہسی اور میں جوان تجھ پہ قربان میری جان میری جان
جب ایسے چکنے چہرے تو کیسے نہ نظر پھسلے تو کیسے نہ نظر پھسلے جند میری
Wow, what an incredible performance. Thank you. Basit Saab, Naseen Basit, that was beautiful. What an incredible way to kick off tonight. We have Iman's parents here celebrating their daughter's wedding. This is beautiful. Next, now that we're a little warmed up, our next performance is going to be by Altaf and Nasreen Godel. Please welcome them, Altaf and Nasreen Godel. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Altaf and Nasreen Godel! Next, I'd like to call for the next performance, Mubarak and Shaheen Awan! Let's give them some love and support, guys. Mubarak and Shaheen Awan!
तेरे हुस्न की क्या तारीफ करूं, तेरे हुस्न की, तेरे हुस्न की क्या तारीफ करूं, कुछ कहते हुए भी डरता हूं, कहीं भूल से तू न समझ बैठे कि मैं तुझसे मोहब्बत करता हूं।
मेरे दिल में कसक सी होती है, मेरे दिल में, मेरे दिल में कसक सी होती है, तेरी राह से जब मैं गुजरती हूँ, इस बात से ये न समझ लेना कि मैं तुझसे मोहब्बत करती हूँ।
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Mubarak and Shaheen Awan. Not gonna lie, that was adorable. That was absolutely adorable. All right, for our next, I think the grown-ups have had a few performances. I think we need to get some young people on the stage. We need to mix it up a little bit. Our next performance, Tardivari Aegi. Okay. But our next performance is gonna be by Taha's siblings. We're gonna have Hamza and Miriam Sayed take the stage with the next performance. Hamza and Miriam Sayed. Oh, wow. Taha, you can sit and enjoy this one. Miriam, Hamza, you guys ready?
तेरे संग यारा अख लड़ने लगी, अख लड़ लड़ के आगे बढ़ने लगी।
एक तेरे संग यारा अख लड़ने लगी, अख लड़ लड़ के आगे बढ़ने लगी।
ओ तेरे दिल के इशारे ये तो पढ़ने लगी।
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Sayed siblings. That was awesome. Our next performance is gonna be now by the Basit family friends, Gulnaz and Aliza.
Thank you. सितारे है चांद समखड़ा क्या कहना उसका आफरी दावत में जैसे हो शाही टुकड़ा उसके जैसी ना कोई नाजनी शाही जोड़ा पहन के आई जो बंधन के वही तो मेरी स्वीट हार्ट है शर्माई सी बगल में जो बैठी है दुल्हन के वही तो मेरी स्वीट हार्ट है शाही जोड़ा पहन के आई जो बंधन के वही तो मेरी स्वीट हार्ट है शर्माई सी बगल में जो बैठी है दुल्हन के वही तो मेरी स्वीट हार्ट है
MashaAllah, that was absolutely adorable. One more time for Gulnaz and Aliza. You girls just stole the show tonight. Wow. Our next performance is going to be by the Sayyid Cousins. Let's make some noise with the Sayyid Cousins, Rayan and Yusha. Wow, watch out, Bollywood. Those two boys were amazing, Rayan and Yusha. Very impressive, very talented young boys. Our next performance is going to be done by the Ada Dance Studio, Ada Dance Academy, which is in Tustin. This is a professional dance school, which we have arranged to perform for all of us tonight. And this is choreographed and instructed by their guru, Opera Bhandari. So ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please give it up for the Ada Dance Academy.
Bumbara, bumbara, shamrang bumbara, دعورا مساورا حباورا دھتی پورتا پہن کے گھوم میں دلی ہو یا آگر
ورلی والے جھمکے پہ جیا لل جائے تو مر لچکائے تو لکھو گر جائے
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for the Adad Dance Academy. What an incredible performance. Our next performance, can I please have Mr. Hrithik Roshan get on the dance floor, Mr. Hrithik Roshan. Oh, I'm so sorry. This is Iman's cousin, Sahil, who's gonna be playing the role of Hrithik Roshan for us tonight. Sahil, take it away.
Sound baja ke red bull. दिल दिल सुन सुन के बारी बारी यहाँ जम के आ जाते सी कमर पे ठुमके उछाल दे
Let's make some noise for Mr. Tiger Shroff over here. Ekdam first class G performance, Tiger. That was amazing. That was amazing. I don't know how we're going to top that. But our next performance, let's welcome the Sayyid cousins, Bilal and Ali. Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for Bilal and Ali over here. The Sayyid family cousins. I can't imagine what it's like performing after Tiger Shroff. Sahil, that was amazing, buddy.
Check this out.
चिकनी चमेली देखी चिकना कमीना देखा चांदनी चिडर होके चीट किया तो सारे तारे बोले गिली गिली अखा मेरी बात तेरी बात ज्यादा बात है बुरी बात खाली में कटोरा लेके आलू भात मुड़ी भात मेरे भी जोगी जी ने रिपीट किया तो साला मैंने तेरे मुंह पे मारा मुक्का
Amazing performance, Bilal and Ali. All right, next, we're going to have a small skit that's going to be performed by the Sayyid cousins. So if we could please have Miriam please join us and guide us for the skit. Miriam, chief executive of logistics over here.
Performance. We're gonna portray the life of the groom, Taha. So our story starts in Dallas, Texas, where he was born. He didn't stay in Dallas very long, though. He spent his childhood in Pakistan, where he spent a lot of time with family, he played cricket, and he did some other interesting activities.
Assalamu alaikum, khawateen o hazrat. Ek pyari si, choti si, shayari. पेश किया जाएगा शहजादे के लिए। वाह वाह, ये जो हल्का हल्का सुरूर है, ये जो हल्का हल्का सुरूर है, ये सारी तेरी नजर का कसूर है। और सुनिए, लड़का था बदसूरत, लड़का था बदसूरत, इसको कैसी मिली लड़की इतनी खूबसूरत। आशिक बन गया शहजादा, आशिक बन गया शहजादा, लेकिन हरकतें उसकी जैसे मेरा परदादा।
Wow, that was beautiful poetry. So eventually our family packed up and left Pakistan. This was around the time he was starting high school. And we ended up moving to Austin, where he picked up some Texan harkatein.
But I've been forgotten, Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, cutting out Joe? But I've been forgotten, Joe. I've been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, cutting out Joe?
He's very cultured. So next came college, and he moved to LA, went to USC.
Yeah!
Go Trojans! And he quickly made some friends. They all started realizing that they had to start navigating their lives as adults pretty quickly, though. But they were just a bunch of idiots.
Three idiots.
Murgi ka jaane ande ka kya hoga? लाइफ मिलेगी या तवे पे फ्राई होगा, कोई ना जाने अपना फ्यूचर क्या होगा। होंठ घुमाओ सीढ़ी बजा के बोल भैया आले
graduated, he got a job, he accomplished a lot in his life. But let's highlight one of the most important moments, which was, of course, when he met Iman.
Kyunki tum hi ho, ab tum hi ho, zindagi ab tum hi ho, chain bhi mera dard. अब तुम ही हो,
थैंक यू।
Our next performance, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna freshen it up a little bit. We're gonna have some of Iman's friends do a quick little performance.
This is something special to all the Bajis and all the Perjoinas. This is Patiala House. In it,
long dalish kara, oh baby, tera jaan se pyara, oh baby, ye chamka dil saada, ke dikh gaya pyar ye Patiala di. दिल हारा ओ बदला में सारा का सारा ओ बेबी जी में गबरू दिलदारा ओ बेबी तेरा यार ये पटियालवी
यार है यार है यार है पटियालवी
पटियाला पैग लगा के नाचूंगा नाचूंगा पटियाला ढोल बजा के कह दूंगा हीरे मेरी जुल्फे तेरी मेरे हाथों की ये लकीरें बुनती जान से प्यारा ओ बेबी ऐ चमका दिल साडा कि दिख गया प्यार ये पटियाला दी
दिलदारा बेबी तेरा यार ये पटियाल भी
मुझसे दूर कहीं ना जा बस यही कहीं रह जा मैं तेरी दीवानी रे अफसोस तुझे है क्या मुझसे दूर कहीं ना जा बस यही कहीं रह जा मैं तेरी दीवानी रे अफसोस तुझे है क्या
तेरी मेरी कहानी नहीं बन गई तू मेरा हो गया मैं तेरी हो गई जहां जाए तू संग मुझे ले
Now. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give it up for Iman's friends. Lovely performance, ladies. Our next performance is going to be from the Sayed family. We're going to have all the cousins from the Sayed family performing next to Gala Gurian. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Rayan, Yusha, and Hamza. Oh, and we have more. Bilal. And Ali, let's give him a warm welcome.
मैं डालू ताल पे भंगड़ाओ तू भी गिद्दा पाले चल रंग जमा दे हमके बने सभी मत वाले येलो बड़ी सॉलिड मस्ती छाई हेलो हेलो टू मच है तुमने लगाई येलो येलो कंट्रोल करो मेरे भाई
ये दिल छन छन बोले हमने सारी चूड़ियां रात बड़ी है मस्ताई तो दिल भर जानी कर ले गल्ला घूड़ियां
Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for the Sayed cousins. Great job, gentlemen. All right, ladies and gentlemen, our next performance is gonna be done by the Ada Dance Academy. This performance is the Ada Dance Academy Part 2, Return of the Ada Dance Academy. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a group of professional Bollywood dancers from the Ada Dance Academy in Tustin. Let's give them a warm welcome. Take it away, ladies. Make some noise with the Ada Dance Academy. What a fun and amazing performance. Very talented ladies from the Ada Dance Academy, a local dance academy located in Tustin, choreographed by Opera Bhandari. Our next performance, we're bringing it back to the Basit family. Our next performance is going to be done by Iman's friends with a special surprise. They're going to be performing to the song Desa da Raja. If you're performing to Desa da Raja and you're Iman's homegirl, please come to the dance floor. And this performance has a very special surprise. Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for Iman and her homegirls. What a lovely and graceful performance. And now our next performance is one very exciting one with a lot of tamaka. Can we please welcome the Taha's buddies, Taha's friends, who are gonna be performing to Sanukendi.
Oh,
Ladies and gentlemen, can we please make some noise for Taha's boys? What an incredible performance from the boys. Adding a little bit Punjabi flavor to the night. And some acrobatics as well. And, you know, I've never seen somebody do acrobatics like that to some Nusrat Fateh Ali Khan. That was a very interesting fusion over there. For this next performance, we're going to have a lot of patake, okay? We're going to have some patake going off. So we're going to need a little bit of distance from the patake, the patakas over here. This is from the Sayed family. Let's make some noise for the Sayed family. The Sayed cousins, the Sayed the boys, Taha's buddies. We also saw some incredible performances from the Basit family. All the cousins, Iman's homegirls, and from the parents as well. What a lovely way we kicked it off. We had some professional Bollywood dancers perform, not once, but twice for us. What an incredible Mehndi party. But now, ladies and gentlemen, our next performance is gonna be done by our bride and groom. Let's please make some noise for Taha and Iman Sayed!
बुलावे तुझे यार आज मेरी गलियां बसाऊं तेरे संग मैं अलग दुनिया बुलावे तुझे यार आज मेरी गलियां बसाऊं तेरे संग मैं अलग दुनिया ना आए कभी दोनों में जरा भी फासले बस एक तू हो एक मैं हूं और कोई ना है मेरा सब कुछ तेरा तू समझ ले तू चाहे मेरे हक की जमीन रख ले तू सांसों पे भी नाम तेरा लिख दे मैं जीऊं जब जब तेरा दिल धड़के
Well, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for these lovebirds. That was so romantic. And choreographed well, too. Great job, Taha and Iman. That was beautiful. Now, our next performance. Yeah, what an incredible night we've had. Incredible dances, incredible performances. Yaar, pangda paun nu ji karda hai. Yaar, badi zor di pangda paun da dil karda hai, yaar. So you know what? I think we need to call some professional bhangra dancers out here. Have you guys heard of UCLA? Everyone here heard of UCLA? Well, you know what, ladies and gentlemen? We've called UCLA's bhangra team to perform here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, let's make some noise for Bruin Bhangra!
Yeah, I'm burning, I'm a creepy, I'm a way loud, huh? Speed in my bones, so I'm चंद टुकड़ा ने तेरी अनक तेरे शू क्या बात है क्या बात है तेरा काजल करता है पागल हिप्नोटाइज करे जगूं क्या बात है क्या बात है कंगना कंगना कंगना
कंगना तेरा नहीं सानू
tonight. We've seen all these performances, and tonight it's your turn to dance.